Gracie's, we're making Rhode Island striped bass. Thanks so much for coming in tonight.
Oh, it's my pleasure.
It's great to have you here. And the ingredients for this recipe look, I mean, they look beautiful. These tomatoes especially.
Well, yeah, it's this time of the year, tomatoes are just starting to come around. Actually picked these up at the farmer's market on Wednesday over at Lippitt Park. There's a couple varieties here, some yellow boys, some brandy wines, and some green zebras.
And, you know, I mean, before we were talking about the tomatoes themselves and you know, the green on top and, you know, the flavor of these tomatoes may be different from the flavor of a tomato some may grow in their backyard or that you may purchase at a market.
Well, that's correct. Conventional tomatoes have bred into them resilience. So basically, they'll hold up better to traveling and to shipping. These tomatoes are heirloom varieties, so the seeds go back 50 to 100 years.
Wow.
So the flavor is just that much more intense, really incredible. We do grow some tomatoes in our rooftop garden, so they're not quite ready yet, but you can grab tomatoes at your local farmer's market.
Sure, perfect. All right, let's see what else we have.
We've got some amazing Rhode Island striped bass, which just happens to be the state fish of Rhode Island. Mm-hmm. So we're cooking some striped bass tonight with some beans from our rooftop garden, as well as some radishes, herbs and flowers, some shallots, and we're going to do a little verjus vinaigrette. So verjus is basically grape juice that they would typically turn into wine, but in this case it adds a nice acidity to the tomatoes, not overpowering like a vinegar would be.
Right.
Nice fruity, light, refreshing, flavor. Perfect dish for the summer.
Perfect. And then just a little
extra virgin olive oil, some pepper, salt, very, very simple, light,
and
delicious.
Ready to go.
You got it.
Okay, perfect. All right, we have the ingredients set to go. In the meantime, back to you.
The kitchen. How's it going, Will?
Hey, Mary, it's going very well. We are back in the Rhode Show kitchen this morning with Chef Matthew Varga from Gracie's, making Rhode Island striped bass. We're going to make the vinaigrette now, right?
Yeah, that's correct. So instead of actually using vinegar, we're using verjus, which is unfermented grape juice, which is made from sour grapes. So it's not as acidic as a vinegar would be. So it lends itself
a better flavor, easier to.
And it's very wine friendly as well. It's not too acidic. So.
And can we get that anyplace?
You can get that at Williams-Sonoma.
Okay.
Or you can get it online.
All right.
All right.
Okay.
So just going to add a little bit of the verjus in there. Okay. A little bit of Dijon, which is going to help to emulsify the olive oil.
Nice.
All right. A little bit of fresh herbs. We've got here some parsley, chervil, and chive.
I mean, now's the time you get all these fresh
exactly right from your garden. Mm-hmm. And these were grown actually in our rooftop garden, which is right down the street from the restaurant. So basically, you want to just start whisking and slowly add in your olive oil. I used a little towel. I put a towel underneath, which helps keep the bowl from sliding around.
All right.
So you just kind of want to just emulsify
and you want to keep whisking as you're going along, just to make sure everything's blended
exactly
together.
If it doesn't come together, that's all right. I mean, this is just going to help season those tomatoes and kind of bring out the natural sweetness. Okay, I'm just going to season that with a little bit of salt.
Okay,
cracked black pepper, which pepper mill's right over there. If you want to hand that to me, beautiful. And then we'll just reserve this for our tomatoes.
Do you feel when you're making something like that? I mean, I know when I grow tomatoes in my yard or something like that, the salt like that, rougher texture salt or the cracked pepper also adds just a better taste than, just a regular
shake. It does. Salt's going to bring out the flavors, the natural flavors of the tomato, and it helps to counteract that acidity, which is in the tomato.
Right.
Really
so
brings out the sweetness.
So then we'll use that, we'll put that on top of these.
We'll put that on the tomatoes, and the striped bass on top of that. Again, really simple, perfect for this time
All
of year.
All good. Okay, we have our ingredients. We've got the vinaigrette ready to go. We'll be back in just a little bit. We'll cook up the bass. Back to you. We're back in the Rhode Show kitchen this morning. Chef Matthew Varga is here from Gracie's, making Rhode Island striped bass. We've got the pans heated.
Pan is heated.
Our ingredients ready to go, so we can start cooking.
All right, so first you want to start off, you're going to heat your pan up, medium-high, all right? Put a little bit of oil
in the pan. What type of oil are we using?
This is just a blended oil, okay? So it's 90% vegetable oil, 10% olive oil.
Okay.
Okay? I'm going to season our striped bass here. Beautiful piece of fish here.
Now, this is Rhode Island striped bass. Is there a different flavor between this and, another type of fish that we would get or bass that we would get?
Well, this bass is going to be a little bit more meaty. It's going to have a firm texture to it. It's going to eat like meat instead of fish. It's not going to be as delicate,
okay.
Which, It's going to tend for a hard sear. You can go skin on or skin off, but you can also throw it right on the grill, perfect this time of year. Excellent.
So, and you really want to make sure that this pan is hot. So
you want to make sure the pan's hot. It's not going to stick. You're going to start to brown up the skin. It's going to start to render and caramelize.
Right.
Perfect.
Okay.
We'll get the tomatoes together. So we had made that vinaigrette earlier. Just pour some tomatoes in there.
Can you explain to everybody about these tomatoes one more time?
These are heirloom variety tomato. So they're a cultivar of seeds that have been about 50 to 100 years old. There's no genetic modifications whatsoever.
Right. And the flavor is much better in these.
The flavor is very intense.
Right.
Okay. So these are just some peeled cherry tomatoes that I've had from the farmer's market. I got from Shartner's Farms. So a little bit of that vinaigrette that we had from earlier.
Sure.
Okay. Season with a little bit more salt. Just going to turn the heat down to about a medium. Season with a little bit more salt and some black pepper.
Okay, we'll get that for you.
Kind of toss this around here. All right, a little bit of black pepper
that
on there.
That looks great. I mean, that, yeah.
Oh, it's beautiful.
Looks that like a great
that on its own is nice.
Right.
Okay, so you got a nice caramelization going on there. We're going to add some of the beans. These beans actually I grew on our rooftop garden, which is
just got a big rooftop.
Two blocks down from the restaurant. It's about 1,000 square feet. This is actually our fifth year that we've been working this garden.
And
so,
for you as a chef, I mean, being able to go up, you know, on the rooftop of the restaurant and being able to pick out the fresh, you know, the fresh ingredients, that's going to inspire you to make, you know, other dishes as well.
Oh, of course. I mean, really, being sustainable, you want to work with what you have. You have to be very versatile. Every evening before service, actually, my crew will actually go up to the garden and we'll harvest herbs, flowers, which we have here, and different garnishes for that evening. I mean, we also grow tomatoes, squash, leeks, cabbage, you name it. It's probably up there. So you got a nice caramelization going on right here. We're going to add a little bit of butter. And baste, see that nice and golden brown?
Okay.
It's a little crispy.
Yep.
Add a little bit of butter.
How, you know, hear how the meat change colors from when it first put out.
Of course. It's going to go from kind of an opaque to a nice white color. Okay. I'm going to just baste a little bit. Okay. I'm going to take this, put it into a 350 degree oven.
All right.
For about 5-6 minutes. Okay.
And let that sit in there for a little
while. Let that sit in there. It's going to get cooked.
Is this fish here, I mean, it's in the oven there. Do we really need to keep an eye on it so that it doesn't dry out, so it doesn't cook too much?
This fish doesn't have really a tendency to dry out. I mean, you want to cook it to about medium, and that's just perfect. Okay.
Right.
And if you like your fish done a little bit less, I mean, medium rare is just fine.
Okay.
Okay, so we got our tomatoes here. You want to do me a favor? You want to do some plating?
Absolutely. We'll take this. I'll bring this over here for you.
Okay.
Now, while we're doing this, tell us about some of the other things that you have going on at the restaurant.
At the restaurant, well, coming up, we've got Restaurant Week.
Oh, yeah.
Which is a three-course prefixed meal. So appetizer, entree, and dessert. $29.95 is a great deal. We'll be running that from July 12th. And for the rest of the month, rest of the month, we're going to be putting out some incredible food, very fresh, local. So we're just going to start by putting some tomatoes on the plate here. I'm actually going to
put those on there.
Yeah.
Let me just.
And it really doesn't matter how you put them on there. I mean, you can just throw them on there.
Just have a little while, just a few seconds left here.
So we're going to grab that fish out of the oven.
Grab that, and you can
right here.
Put that on there. So we can show everybody what it looks like when it's done.
Perfect. All right, we're going to get that on there just like that. Really simple. Finish with a couple more tomatoes.
Put that on there.
Some beans.
It looks great. It screams summer. If you want this recipe.
Finish it with a little bit of herbs.
Put that on there too.
And flowers from our rooftop garden.
Thanks, man, for coming in. If you want this recipe, you can head to WPRI.com.